There's a new recent update that just came out in Forza Horizon 5. It's a new expansion. This is the second expansion of Forza Horizon 5. It's called Rally Adventure. And so now I'm going to demonstrate what you could do to your vehicle to prepare it for the Rally Championship. So we have a new upgrade here, which I will go over here. There's a new turbocharger called anti-lag. So I'll demonstrate here when you rev it up. You can hear all those pops and bangs and stuff at the end of the exhaust. Almost sounds like a gunshot, basically. That happens when you do a lot of two-stepping and stuff like that. So basically that's the anti-lag, which means that it never lags. It just keeps on going until it lets off excess exhaust pressure and stuff like that. And a lot of tuners love this kind of turbocharger because this gives them immediate throttle response and no lag. So it'll make a turbocharger a lot more powerful to its full potential when you turbocharge any engine in this game. This goes for single and twin turbo applications in Forza Horizon 5, as they do in real life. So what the anti-lag is, I'll show you here. It doesn't actually have any power and performance differences. It's the same as the ordinary race twin turbo setup. So you have to have the race twin turbo installed or just any turbocharger installed, but it's basically a race spec turbo with anti-lag. So it's for racing cars only, and this is not for road use. So it's the same power and torque as I've had before, 1,307 horsepower and 1,003 foot-pounds, using the TVR's Cibera Speed 12 engine swap, which I have swapped in my Corvette C7 Z06 here, my favorite car, which I call Sport Monster, and this is what I want my real car to look like in the future. Now, I did another upgrade to my car, actually a few other upgrades, to make it worthy for off-roading and rallying. So I had a rally springs and damper suspension setup installed, and a rally spec tire compound installed as well, so I can handle rougher terrain and dirt and snow, whatever. So this can go off-road with ease, and it's already all-wheel drive, so that shouldn't be an issue. But you can also get an off-road tire compound, which can help even further, but for the rally's sake, we'll just keep it a rally tire. So that'll really help it going off-road. And so, I'm going to demonstrate what each race is. Well, not each race. So we're going to do basically two different races. We're going to do the same track, but two different modes of it. So we're in nighttime, but there's a few different events here. So we're going to start off with the dirt rally, which is the most popular. So basically this is a sprint race or a dirt trail from point A to B. And here, there are two race modes that you can do. I've already completed the rally mode, which I'm going to demonstrate you here. Then after that, we'll do the race mode. So the rally mode basically means it's a race against the clock. You follow your co-driver's commands and pace notes and check your times at the split gates. Basically, you drive as fast as you can against the clock. So this is what we'll do here. And I'm ready. Let's go.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go!
And there's Alex.
Easy right.
So, as you can hear, he's calling out the commands for the turns that come up, and I have to follow them exactly as he says.
Easy left.
Yep.
Hairpin right.
so I have to keep following this while listening to my co-driver's commands.
Hard left. Like, left.
That's a split time that I just passed, so I need to get up in front of them, in front of the others that are ahead of me, if I can. This can get annoying sometimes with them shouting out these commands, but eventually you get it, though. You get the idea. But still, you know, these are not real co-drivers, basically. They're like the in-game hosts in Horizon 5, which are very annoying, and they never shut up. So, yeah, that's why. But, of course, this is helpful if you're new to rallying. That's for sure. And I don't think I'm doing as good as my first time was. Woo! Gotta be careful here. Just gotta keep going. There we go. Just gotta keep going. We're about 70% in. We're getting there. Split.
To bumps. Easy right. Easy left. Hairpin right. Medium left. Easy left. Flat out.
Flat out. That means straight ahead.
Water. Followed by easy left. Easy right. Flip to the floor.
Here's the finish line. Here we go. And the rally is complete. Although I finished sixth, though, because basically I already finished it, but I accidentally missed that turn a little bit there. But still, you get the idea. Basically, that's all you got to do for rallying. Just follow your co-driver's commands, and then basically go as fast as you can against the clock. That wasn't my best time, unfortunately, but it's just what I demonstrated, so you can get the idea. Now, I'm going to show you the race mode. I already completed it on this track, so basically this means the Horizon race is the racing you know and love. You versus a pack of other drivers on the thrilling roads of Sierra Nevada. And I forgot to mention that this new location that we're at, that we're now in, it's called Sierra Nevada. It's also still in Mexico, but it's a little bit, I think it's a bit north or east or so, or west to the main map of Horizon 5. It's got, but it's around there. It's still a map of Mexico.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go!
And here are the other drivers that are competing against me. Now I have to beat all of them. This time Alex is not shouting his annoying commands. At least that. So now all we could do was just focus on beating everyone else. These guys are pretty tough. Whoa! Okay, I almost veered off track there when I hit that Mustang. Luckily, the rewinding feature helps. And there's the top three. Let's go after them. Got better traction with my rally tires on dirt. Ooh. A little bit scary, but gotta hang in there best you can, you know, when it comes to rallying. Oh, looks like I got an achievement. Don't know what it is, but I'll look at it later. Oh, man, that distracted me from getting in that checkpoint. Ah, Mr. Monster 6092. That's a cool gamer tag. Go ahead and overtake him if I can. Yep. Now to get Lizard 056. Or Lizard 56. Whoa. Yeah, these turns are really tight. I mean, correct me if I'm wrong, but I think Mexico is known for having very tight turns in their roads. Oh man, that was rough. All right, Lizard, come here. 75%. Oh man, Lizard's ahead of me. But I guess as best I could do Lizard now. Whoa! Yeah, you really do lose a lot of traction with the rally tires on tarmac. But when it comes to this expansion, that's what you need. For gravel and mud and snow and grass and just any kind of uneven terrain. Well, at least I finished this race before, but you get the idea. So that's the dirt rally. There are two other kinds of rally events that you can compete in here, which I'll show you in a minute. Okay, free JDM car, not bad. And another kind of rally is the road rally. So this is where we'll basically have all the tarmac to use on this course that we're doing here. So there's no dirt anywhere in the road rally. Really? $1,000? Come on. Could do better than that. So, same as before, I'll go over the rally mode again. Racing against the clock again, even though I already completed it. I'm still demonstrating. Unfortunately, I may not have the best traction on the tarmac with the rally tires, but I'll give it the best I can.
Medium right.
And then this time, Alejandra, who is basically the chick in this game who helps you out. So she does the road rally.
Easy right. Into easy left.
I mean, she's not as annoying as Alex. Thank God. But her cousin, Ramiro, or Rami, as he likes to be called, he's even more annoying, which I'm gonna show at the end of this. So now I'm following Alejandra's commands this time on the road sprint rally. It's also a sprint from point A to B. This time I'm still racing against the clock, just like I did with Alex, but this time Alejandra is in command. Some of these others are pretty tough on me, so. Okay, I'm doing a little bit better than the first one. Square right, yeah, that's a very tight one right there.
Medium right, then medium left.
Yep, there's a lot of mediums and easy and hard turns here. It varies depending on the terrain that you're on and the kind of route that you're following.
Followed by medium left. Onto bridge.
Alright, going on a bridge. Whoa! That wasn't supposed to happen. Next split coming up.
Medium right.
Oh, back medium in third left. Again.
Hard left.
Almost to the end.
Medium right. Into medium left. Onto bridge. Medium right.
Whoa. And we finished. Came in second, not bad. Although that wasn't my best time. Because like I said, I did not have that good of traction on this because of my rally tire setup. And now we're gonna do another road rally, but this time an actual sprint race from point A to B on tarmac. Okay, so I haven't done this one yet, so I'm going to go ahead and complete this one, the race mode, on this course here. Once again, I apologize if there are any lags or glitches on here, on my iPad app for Xbox. Even though I'm using my Xbox Series X, you know, my internet may still have some issues and stuff. And now let's start the road rally race.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go!
Here we go. Whoa. I'm racing against all these guys just on tarmac. Big jump there. Uh-oh. Missed a checkpoint. This time Alejandra is not shouting her commands, so that gives us better concentration. Just like with all road sprints and stuff like that. And dirt sprints, cross-country sprints, you name it. Okay, I just gotta get Sir Brotaco, whoever that is. He's holding me on pretty good. Right now he's in the lead in that Cadillac CTSV. I don't know if I can get him, but he's pretty far up. Even in highly skilled, some of these guys can still be tough. And I'm not getting that good traction. Well, it's because I got my rally terrain tires on, so that's why. But of course, on all, you just gotta give it your best. Whoa, this is like tricky S curves right here. Man, Sir Brotaco is not even giving up. He's holding on there very good, I can see. And he's fast. Don't get me wrong, he's very, very quick. But I'm catching up a little bit, see if I can overtake him. Getting a little bump, and there I overtook him. Oh. There we go. Wow, now that was tough. But in the end, I managed to make it. Sorry, my dad. There was a little lag spike connection issue. But still, I won. Wow. That was tough, but in the end, I managed to make it. Not bad. Yeah, there's a little bit of lags going on, so keep that in mind. Now, I'm going to show you the final part of the rally expansion, which this one is basically the night rally. As the name implies, it takes place in the night on dirt and uneven terrain. This time, Ramiro, aka Remy, is the announcer, and he does the commands, the turn commands, the hill commands, and all that, you know, the pace notes, basically. So he does all those for the night rally, so it's going to be a little bit harder to see, so let's see what we can do. Although Remy is pretty annoying in this game, not gonna lie. He's okay, but he's still pretty annoying. Like, a lot of the characters in this game are pretty annoying. I mean, they're way too friendly, and they don't really give you any competition or threats or anything. Which, in my opinion, would definitely make it more interesting. There's not really any bad guys or villains in this game, which is kind of boring.
3, 2, 1, go!
And that's Remy.
Right, followed by easy left. Medium right, so, into hairpin left.
Whoa, so we gotta follow these checkpoints. Whoa. It's a little bit slippery here.
Medium left, hairpin right.
Some tarmac, hopefully we'll probably get off road
soon. Easy right, let's see. Hard left. Flat out. Right.
We're gonna lead here. There we go.
Hairpin left. Easy left. Then medium right. Easy left. Pressed. Medium
so, yeah,
right.
It's raining and it's
then
so hard to see.
Change the turn.
Okay, so here now we're on dirt.
Medium left.
Going off road again.
Easy left, then crest.
Here we go.
Medium right, then bumps. Hard left.
Whoa, out of control here. It gets unpredictable
medium
at night,
left.
Especially when you're going off road.
Hard
in
right, into medium right. Medium left, followed by bumps. Right. Easy left. Medium left. Medium right. Water. Into medium left.
So far, we're getting there.
Onto the asphalt.
At least the helicopter can provide
Press.
An extra spotlight, so you can
left
see
out.
A little bit more. Now we're back on tarmac.
Easy left, crest, easy left, then medium left. Onto bridge, medium right, into medium left. Medium right, easy right, medium left.
And that is the night rally. Next will be a night sprint race. And also, you won't be able to hear Ramiro's annoying commands. So at least that. Okay, we'll just drive to this one here. I haven't done the race part yet, so I'll go ahead and do it.
arrived at your destination.
We'll go ahead and complete the race mode here with the night rally. Still follow you at least and provides a good spotlight. Of course, you don't hear the annoying commands though. Control there. Portion is done. And that's basically what you're going to do in the rally expansion of Forza Horizon 5. There's only about, I'd say, I think about 18 races here in Sierra Nueva to do. So it's not much. Probably not as much stuff to do as Hot Wheels, because Hot Wheels had a lot of stuff to do, but Hot Wheels was great. I mean, this expansion's pretty cool, though. I'm not going to lie, it's a great expansion. But let's put it this way, both this and Hot Wheels are significantly better than when we got Lego back in Horizon 4. I think we can all agree on that. So yeah, that's for sure. And now, I'm going to show you the different team selects here on the Rally Adventure widget here. So there are three different teams that you could join from Alex, Alejandra, and Ramiro. So Alex is in charge of the dirt rally, whereas Alejandra is in charge of the road rally, and Ramiro is in charge of the night rally. So these are known as the Horizon Raptors, Apex Predators, and Grit Reapers, respectively. So they have different tasks that you can do to get either different vehicles, clothing, or skins, or different reputation points. And I'm all the way at max level, which is 9, So I got every vehicle and clothing item here. You can also get wheel spins too on various difficulties or different challenges that you can do. You get the idea. Yep, same goes for this. I didn't complete all these. I mean, you don't have to complete them all, but you can complete as many as you want. So yeah, I think you get the idea. Now, we're all gonna head back to the main map of Horizon Mexico, so that I'll now demonstrate the other vehicles that came with this expansion. I have them organized under my favorites list, so that way I'll know which vehicles are them. And I'm gonna customize them and tune them up a little bit later, but I'll show you the customizations before I apply them.
Welcome back, Steven.
Because I'm not gonna actually film myself applying them, because that would take a long time to do. But I will test them, though. And so, I'm gonna show you all. I'm gonna go to favorites here. These are all the vehicles that came with the Horizon Rally Championship. So we have two new Alumicraft vehicles. This one is a Class 1 buggy with a beautiful Chevrolet LS or LT V8 in the rear. A lot faster than the Class 10, which is a tiny four-cylinder with less than 200 horsepower. This one's got 500, which is much better. But it's only rear-wheel drive, so it may not be great, but, you know, if you put all-wheel drive on this, it'll be a lot better. Same with this truck here. This one is called the Trick Truck. I mean, I'm not sure if it's a... I think it's a Chevrolet. I think it is. And it's probably got a LS Chevrolet V8 under the hood. Probably a LS3, I think. Makes 430 horsepower and torque all around. It weighs nearly 6,000 pounds, nearly 3 tons. Now that's heavy. So yeah, this'll rock it out in C-Class. And then next we have a custom Jeep made by Casey Curry Motorsports. This is called the Trophy Jeep for the Ultra 4 class of off-road buggy racing. So this one has a 454 cubic inch V8. I don't know if it's a Chevrolet or Ford. I mean, it could be a Chevrolet. I mean, it's gotta be. And it makes 850 horsepower and 650 torque naturally aspirated. And these two are naturally aspirated as well. Both V8s, which I love. And this is an A-Class. And this one's all-wheel drive. And it's a little bit lighter than the Trick Truck, but about 1,100 pounds heavier than the Class 1 buggy. And next to it is the Ford Focus RS 2001 rally spec car, driven by famous race car driver Colin McRae. So this is one of Colin McRae's cars. If you've seen Colin McRae, you know he's a monster on the rally circuit. He's one of the best rally drivers to ever hit the rally circuit and different rally tracks. I mean, he's dominated tons of rally championships. Correct me if I'm wrong, but I heard he's one of the best in rally driving. So yeah, this is his car. And this actually already has the anti-lag turbocharger installed. And this makes 300 horsepower and 332 foot-pounds of torque. Weighs 2,802 pounds. Four-cylinder with the anti-lag turbo installed, all-wheel drive. And here is another Hoonigan car. It is the Volkswagen Baja Beetle Class 5 1600, known as the Scumbug. And it's rear-wheel drive. It makes only 146 horsepower and 166 torque. And but it's very light. It weighs just under 2,200 pounds. And it's two-wheel drive. It's rear-wheel drive. But if that were all-wheel drive, that would be insane. And next we have another trophy truck. This is by Jimco. And it has the same Chevrolet V8 as the Alumicraft Trick Truck does. Could be the LT1 or LS3, either one. It's called the Fastball Racing Spec Trophy Truck by Jimco. And it weighs 5,100 pounds dry, so it's definitely lighter than the Trick Truck, that's for sure. And right under here, we have an even more powerful Class 1 buggy here, also by Jimco. And it's actually light, too. It's called the Hammerhead Class 1 buggy by Jimco. 7.8 liter V8. So, yeah, that thing is huge. That's got to be maybe a 468 or maybe a 482. I don't know, but it could be, yeah. I mean, it's not exactly 500 cubic inches, so it's a bit less than that, but it's close to it, though. And it makes 850 horsepower and 800 foot-pounds of torque, naturally aspirated. Weighs just shy under 2 tons, under 4,000 pounds. Rear-wheel drive in A-class, whereas the Jimco trophy truck is in B-class. And the Baja Beetle is in A-class, and Colin McRae's Ford Focus RS is in A-class. Same with the Ultra 4 Jeep. And next to it is another Polaris RZR Pro. It's called the XP Factory Racing Limited Edition. And it's a high-performance UTV that should be more powerful than its original version, the XP 1000, which is already in Forza. And this has, I think, a two-cylinder engine with a turbocharger. I think it's a two-cylinder, or maybe it's a four-cylinder. I don't know how many cylinders it has. It's either a, but it's not a V-twin. It's got to be an inline twin or a straight twin or something like that. It's got to be a two-cylinder. It's probably a two-cylinder, yeah. But it's turbocharged, and it makes 181 horsepower and 120 foot-pounds of torque. And it weighs just shy over a ton at 2,060 pounds. Engine is less than a liter in displacement. All-wheel drive, and it's in C-class. Next to it is one of my personal favorites, which is the RJ Anderson trophy truck. It's another RJ Anderson number 37 Polaris RZR trophy truck. This one's called the RZR Pro 4 truck. And there already is another RJ Anderson trophy truck in here, but we'll have to see how this compares to that. So that's for another day. But this one makes 846 horsepower and 642 foot-pounds of torque, naturally aspirated. Weighs just a little over 2 tons at 4,329 pounds. And it's gotta have a bored and stroked LS7 in there. 427 small block Chevrolet, but it's gotta be bored and stroked, I think. Maybe a 434 cubic inch or something like that. I mean, it could be. I may be wrong, but yeah, it's got to be around there. But yeah, I can tell it's been bored and stroked. It's got to be an LS7. And it's all-wheel drive, and it's an A-class, so that'll be great. And it sounds great, too. I've driven it before, and it's amazing. In fact, I've driven all these. Well, not all of them, but most of them. But I'm going to test them out on the highway, see how they perform stock at their stock speeds and all that. But before I do all that, I'm going to go ahead and view what upgrades you can install on them. So, you got your basic engine upgrades here. Basically all your engine upgrades, basic. Here you have your brakes and front anti-roll bars, and this is all for the Alumacraft Class 1 buggy. Drivetrain, it's all the same as other vehicles. Tires, you only get increased tire width, you get different wheels, and you can get different rim sizes too. You can also do a drivetrain swap and make it all-wheel drive, which I will do in another time. So here for engine swaps, we can either have the stock 6.2 small block Chevrolet LS V8, or the LT, whichever one. It's got to be a LS3 or a LT1. I mean, it's got to be either one. Probably a LS3, I think. Or it's an LS base, though. It's LS. So either that, or we'll give it the V12 from the TVR Sabura Speed 12, or the Racing 7.2 liter V8, or the 440 cubic inch V8, or 442 cubic inch V8 from the other RJ Anderson trophy truck. As you can see, it's a lot lighter than the LS here, which is interesting. Don't know why, despite being bigger and more powerful. And let's look at its performance stats real quick. Oops. Not very fast. But it does do 0 to 60 in 2.7 seconds, or 2.8 seconds. 0 to 100 miles an hour is 7.4 seconds, but top speed is only 134.5 miles an hour. But that can change with upgrades and a tune. And it's got less than one lateral G of cornering force at 60 and 100 miles and 120 miles an hour respectively, 0.89 G. And braking from 60 to 0 in 129 feet, and braking from 100 miles an hour to 0 in 321 feet. So it's all right. Next. We'll check out the other Alumacraft, the Trick Truck. See what we can do to it. Basic engine upgrades here. You could do brakes and front and rear anti-roll bars, and even a weight reduction on a racing truck. That's interesting. Transmission, driveline, differential, we already know that. Increased tire width, different rims and rim size. And we can also turbocharge it, because this is naturally aspirated. You can install a twin turbo if you want, which can give you 680 horsepower and 680 torque, but that's actually 679, but technically that's 680, so it's close to 700. So here are the performance stats. Ooh, it's pretty slow, 0 to 60 miles an hour in nearly 5 seconds, so that's 4.8 seconds. 0 to 100 miles an hour in 13.8 seconds. Top speed is 120.2 miles per hour. Man, that's slow. For a racing truck, that is stupidly slow. Lateral G's is less than the Alumacraft buggy, with 0.85 and 0.84 G's respectively at 60 and 120 miles an hour. Eesh. Oh, yeah. We can also make it all-wheel drive, which I'll do at a later time. For engine swaps, we could do also the TVR Subaru V12 or the Racing Pro Truck 7.2 liter V8 from one of the RJ Anderson trophy trucks. And next, we'll look at the Ultra 4 Jeep. We have fewer engine upgrades on this. Just throttle body, fuel system, ignition, flywheel, and displacement. Bore and stroke increase. We just have brakes here. Transmission and differential here. Increased tire width, rim style, and increased rim size. Drivetrain, we could swap it from all-wheel drive to rear wheel. I don't know why anybody would ever want to do that. Because, hey, you got to have four-wheel drive if you're doing rock crawling and off-road racing. So, yeah, you got to have four-wheel drive. For engine swaps, we can also do the TVR Subaru Speed 12 V12 in here, or the Pro Truck V8 from the RJ Anderson Trophy Truck. Pretty interesting how those have the same swaps. All three of these do. And next, I'll look at Colin McRae's Ford Focus RS. Oh yeah, and if you look here on the side, there is Colin McRae's name right there on the window. That's the driver for this car. And the secondary driver for this car whose name is Grist. I don't know his first name, and I don't know where he's from, but he was probably the secondary driver for this car, and he was probably Colin McRae's teammate. I mean, I may be wrong, but I think so. Let me know who this Grist driver is and all that, so I won't, you know, be confused or think I didn't know. I don't know. But of course, everyone knows Colin McRae, so at least that. Let's see what we can do for upgrades. Yep, basic engine upgrades here. Except this is restricted, so you can remove restrictors, although that only adds about 42 extra horsepower, which is not that much. Here we can do brakes, different springs and dampers, and a weight reduction in an already lightweight rally car. For transmission, driveline, and differential here, we can add a... Ooh, check this out. We can have rally-style fog lights on the grille. That's interesting. Although that does add a little bit of weight. Or does it? Let's check that out. Yep, that adds about 4 extra pounds of weight. I mean, it's okay. It might not make much of a difference, but who knows. And here, we can actually have different profiles of tires here. For this car, we can have semi-slick race tires and drift tires and even slick tires or semi-slick tires and stuff like that. This one's from Hot Wheels with that red bead or strip. That looks pretty cool. Or a proper off-road tire or a snow tire or a drag tire. That's interesting. Definitely give you different builds for this car if you decided to make it into a different build. It's got OZ Racing wheels on it. You can change the front and rear tire width and change the front and rear rim size. And you could put tire spacers as well. You can give it a little bit of a wider stance and increase stability. Change rims as well. Let's see if we could do it here. We could change drivetrain from four-wheel drive to rear wheel, but I don't see why anybody would want to do that. That'd make it stupid. So this is a rally car. It's got to be four-wheel drive. What's the point of a rally car if it ain't four-wheel drive? That doesn't make any sense. For engine swaps, we just have one, and that's the 2.1-liter four-cylinder turbo, and that's got to be from the Hoonigan Ford RS500. Or RS200, excuse me. Why did I say RS500? RS200. That's got to be from that. So yeah, that'll really bump the power. But let's see how fast this goes. This goes 0 to 60 miles per hour in 3.1 seconds flat. 0 to 100 miles per hour in 7.9 seconds flat. Top speed, 139 miles per hour, which is decent for a car of this kind and type. 1.1 G at 60 miles an hour and 1.12 G at 120 miles an hour, or 1.12 G or whatever you say, like that. Braking from 60 miles per hour to zero in 107.2 feet. Braking from 100 miles an hour to zero in 280.6 feet. So, not too bad. Yeah, not bad. Let me see, did I go over the other ones that I had there? Top speed? Wait, I don't know if I did this one. Let me just double check. I think I missed this one here with the stats. Let me just go and view it again. Oops. Oh, okay. Yeah, I forgot the stats on this, so... This does 0 to 60 miles per hour in 2.7 seconds, which is pretty quick for a very heavy vehicle. Wow. Especially for a heavy off-roader. Wow, that's pretty quick. 0 to 100 miles per hour in 5 seconds, almost 5 seconds flat. 5.046 seconds to be exact. Top speed is 140.3 miles per hour. That's decent. And, 0.91 G at 60 miles an hour and 0.9 G at 120 miles an hour, which is decent. Not too bad, but decent. Braking distance is 119 feet from 60 miles an hour to zero and 302 feet from 100 miles an hour to zero. So I'm actually rounding up those two. I know it's 118.9 and 301.8, but, you know, it's basically the next number up. So, yeah. I round that up. Okay. Now that we have covered that... Oops. Here we'll do the Hoonigan Volkswagen Baja Beetle. See what you can do to it. Basic engine stuff, and this one's carbureted. No fuel injection here. Brakes and front and rear anti-roll bars. Clutch, transmission, driveline, and differential. You can only do different rims and rim styles. You can't change the tire profile at all, or the size, which is kind of dumb in my opinion. You can either leave it naturally aspirated or swap in a turbocharger. Let's look at the performance stats here. Oh man, this thing is stupidly slow. Let's see, 0 to 60 miles per hour in 5.7 seconds, 0 to 100 miles per hour in a whopping 22.6 seconds. Now that's laughably slow, and top speed is only 103 miles per hour. That is laughably slow. And lateral G's is the same as the Ultra 4 Jeep with 0.91 G at 60 miles per hour and 0.9 G at 120 miles an hour, breaking from 60 miles per hour to zero in 142.6 feet, breaking from 100 miles an hour to zero in 350 feet flat. So yeah, there isn't much you could do on that. You definitely want to have this swap to all-wheel drive. That would make it so much better. Makes it a little faster, but of course, with tuning and upgrades, it'll be a monster. It will. Yeah. So much for the scumbag, it's slow. But these engine swaps are guaranteed to make this car a hell of a lot faster. So you can swap in a Honda Civic VTEC 4-cylinder, 2-liter VTEC, VVT, or a 2-liter flat 4 turbo from the Subaru WRX STI Impreza, or the 2.5-liter flat 4 turbo from another Subaru WRX STI Impreza. And you can have the 2-liter turbo rally flat 4 from the Subaru racing car, whatever it's called. Or you can have the 4-liter flat 6 from the Porsche 911 GT3. Now this will make this car a monster. It will, definitely. Next, let's see. We have the Jimco's. So, for this one, we just have basic engine upgrades here, brakes and weight reduction here, transmission, driveline, and differential here, increased tire width, increased rim size and different rim style, engine swap, or you can swap it from rear-wheel drive to all-wheel drive, which, of course, that is a must for something like this. You can also turbocharge it if you want. Whoa, which gives it a whopping 286 horsepower just with the twin turbos added. Wow, wow. So the twin turbos bump the power up from 495 horsepower and 450 foot-pounds of torque to a whopping 781 horsepower and 710 foot-pounds of torque. Now that will make this a monster. Wow. And I guess the body design kind of looks like a Ford almost. I mean, it could have a Chevrolet engine, but a Ford body. I mean, yeah, it definitely looks like an F-150. It does, yeah. And for engine swaps, we can also do, again, the 7.7 liter TVR Subaru Speed 12 V12, or the racing 7.2 liter V8 from the RJ Anderson trophy truck. Oh, my bad, I forgot to check the stats here. Let's see what the stats are for this. Not so good top speed, but overall pretty decent. 0 to 60 miles per hour in 4.6 seconds. 0 to 100 miles per hour in 12.567 seconds. Top speed is 123 miles per hour. I mean, it's okay, but not as good as I thought. It's probably in the gearing, I guess. And lateral G's is 0.88 G's at 60 miles an hour and 0.87 G's at 120 miles per hour. Braking distance from 60 miles per hour to zero in 124.2 feet. 100 miles an hour to zero in 311.7 feet, or 312 feet, if you will. Okay, next. The other Jimco, the Hammerhead Class 1. Let's see what we could do to this. Whoa! You can only do the flywheel on the engine, which is only 2 pounds lighter. What? That's kind of weird. With only 850 horsepower, come on, there's gotta be at least a turbo conversion or something, who knows. And we only have brakes, and front anti-roll bars and weight reduction. We also have transmission and differential. Oops. And here we have increased tire width, increased rim size and get rim style. And drivetrain, we can change it from rear-wheel drive to all-wheel drive, which should definitely be a lot better in the long run. Engine swaps, we have, again, the TVR Speed 12 V12 and the RJ Anderson Racing 7.2-liter V8. And now let's look at the stats here. Whoa! Okay, it's pretty fast. It's a little bit faster than the trophy truck version. So this does 0 to 60 in 3.25 seconds, and 0 to 100 miles per hour in 5.83 seconds. Top speed is 152 miles per hour. Lateral G's is 0.9 G's at 60 miles an hour and 0.89 G's at 120 miles an hour. Braking from 60 miles per hour to zero in 139 feet flat. Braking from 100 miles an hour to zero in 355 feet flat. Next, we'll look at Polaris RZR. There's like two or three versions of this thing. It's crazy. Let's see what we can do to this. Basic engine tuning here. All your stuff for the engine here. We only have brakes and front anti-roll bars. I don't know why it doesn't have a front anti-roll bar installed. We also have transmission, driveline, and differential. And for tires and rims, we have upgrade tire width, different rim style, rear rim, front and rear rim size, and increased tire profile, which is interesting. You can actually increase the profile size of your tires and make them larger and bigger than ever before, which would be really cool. And now, for drivetrain swap, we could swap this from all-wheel drive to rear-wheel, but why would you want to make it rear-wheel drive? Why? That doesn't make sense. It's got to be all-wheel. Come on, keep it all-wheel and call it a day. It's already perfect all-wheel drive. Don't want to make it worse. Come on. For engine swaps, we can do the four-cylinder superbike engine. It's probably from maybe a Suzuki Hayabusa or a Kawasaki Ninja or a Honda CBR series bike. Either one of those. 1340cc displacement. Or the four-cylinder turbo rally. 300 horsepower, 332 torque. Or see what we could do to this. So we'll see what happens. Next. Oh, wait. My bad. I forgot to look at stats. Oh, man. This thing is stupidly and laughably slow. Wow. 0 to 60 miles per hour in a whopping 5.24 seconds. And it never hits 100 miles per hour. So that fails. So you can see the failed word next to 0 to 100 miles an hour. Same with braking from 100 miles an hour to 0. It doesn't do that because it doesn't even hit 100. But hey, with upgrades or an engine swap and proper tuning, it'll go way over 100. I know it will. And braking from 60 miles an hour to 0 in 141.1 feet. Lateral Gs is 0.91 Gs at 60 miles an hour and 0.90 Gs at 120 miles an hour. So that will need some serious tuning to make this a real monster. And here we go. Last but not least, one of my personal favorites, the other RJ Anderson Polaris RZR trophy truck. It's a Pro 4. Let's see what we can do to it. For engine, we have your basic engine upgrades, just intake, manifold, fuel system, flywheel, bore and stroke the block, and ignition. Here we have brakes, front anti-roll bars, and weight reduction, transmission and differential, increase front or rear tire width, increase front or rear rim size, and give different rim style. And why would you want to swap this from all-wheel drive to rear-wheel? That doesn't make sense. Come on, that makes it worse. Oh, look, Baja Jerky, tear off a piece. I mean, hey, that reminds me of Chick-fil-A almost, but they don't make jerky, though. And for engine swaps, we can do the same 7.7 liter V12 from the TVR Speed 12, or we can also do the monster LSX 454 twin turbo small block Chevrolet V8 from the Funko Motorsports F9 buggy, making a whopping 1,750 horsepower and 1,475 foot-pounds of torque, which is insane. Wow. Can't wait to test them all out. So now I'm going to test out their stock form, starting with the Pro 4 trophy truck, RJ Anderson 2021. I'm going to go ahead and test it out on the highway, see how fast it'll go. Oh yeah, and another thing I forgot to show you is launch control. So when you hold the handbrake and the accelerator at the same time, the vehicle revs stop at a certain RPM. For instance, it's stopping just a little bit over 3,000 RPM. Maybe 3,300 something RPM right there that it's revving at. So the launch control holds it in place, and then when you release the handbrake, it will make a perfect launch with little to no tire spin whatsoever. And here we go. So it's pretty quickly for a truck like this. And it's a six-speed transmission. features the inside of it. All bare bones, clean and simple. Because it's a racing truck, what would you expect? I'm hitting its maximum top speed, as of now. But I think it'll go slightly faster. Let's see, once it gets to a downhill. This LS7 sounds amazing. It's gotta be an LS7. I mean, it definitely sounds like one, and it's gotta be a board and stroke version of that, definitely. Or just LS-based. It might not actually be an LS7, but it's gotta be LS-based. Could be. And this definitely looks like a Chevrolet, if you look at it. It kinda does. I apologize for some of the lag spikes of my iPad app from the Xbox. It's not doing the best job at filming, but it's doing okay. Okay, 155 miles per hour, not bad. Let's go ahead and change and go to start at the back here. To the Alumacraft, and then test out its top speed on the highway. I think we'll start right at about here. Yeah, there we go. This one also has launch control, but you can switch it off if you so desire. Slightly different looking interior than the truck. It's got some electronic computer gauges as well. Extra rims and stuff like that. That's pretty cool. There's your speed right there.
You have arrived at your destination.
Okay, just cruising along at 135 miles per hour. I'm sorry that, you know, my system's kind of lagging a little bit. I don't know why. I mean, sometimes it works better in certain situations, sometimes it doesn't, but, you know, this app really does have a lot of issues of keeping up, so I apologize with that. Going a little over 140, 141. Okay, that's decent. And now we'll go to the Alumacraft Trick Truck. Test out its top speed. But it's got a weak launch due to how heavy it is and poorly geared. Whoa, look at that. It's got a computer screen on the passenger side where a glove box would normally be. That's pretty cool. So this is three screens in this cab, which is really interesting. Hmm. Interesting. A lot of lag spikes on this app. I apologize for it. It's not the best. I think maybe if I do a future video filming on my Xbox consoles, I think maybe I'll just probably see if I can make a video from the console itself. So then it will eventually show up on my Xbox app, so then I can save it from the photo album. I think I'll probably try that. So within, I don't, you know, have to deal with those lag spikes and glitches. But at the same time, I don't have a microphone for that, so it might not pick up my voice if I basically do some talking and stuff. That'd be a little difficult to do. So I need to figure that out. 127, 128. 129, come on, hit 130, come on, baby! Oh, almost. Oh, it's a 3-speed transmission. Wow, that's interesting. Next, we will do... the Ultra 4 Jeep. This one's fast. All right. This one's probably also got a 3-speed transmission too. And also it has a computer screen on the passenger side glove box. That's interesting. Yeah, it could be distracting for the driver as well. But I think that's only for the co-driver to read, for the so the real driver could listen to his commands. But still, I can kind of see why that could be distracting for the actual driver as well. As cool as that looks, it could be distracting if you're in an actual race. So, gotta keep your eyes on the road and off the screens, basically. Good. Cruise is pretty good. Quite a bit of body roll there. Let's see. For the 150, if you can. Oh, 148. Well, that's close enough. Okay. Next we have Colin McRae's Ford Focus RS. Can see and hear the anti-lag turbo at work, as well as the two-step launch control. So yeah, this is basically two-stepping, if you will, with the anti-lag turbo. You can see the flames coming out of the exhaust rapidly. Spools up quick, never lags, hence why it's called anti-lag. The interior has been gutted and stripped. Just a digital dashboard instrument cluster right there in the center of where in front of the steering wheel is. And top speed is unfortunately limited to 139 miles an hour, so not as fast as I thought, but it's decent. But still, it'll go a lot faster when I tune it. Now for the scumbug, which I know will take forever to hit at least 100 miles per hour. Okay, that's 60. All gutted and stripped, kind of a custom looking dashboard. I like that. Aftermarket steering wheel, it's probably like an RNG, I think that's what it's called. There's 100! It's got a roll cage surrounding it, like all these racing vehicles do. They've got roll cages all surrounding it to protect the driver and possibly the co-driver from injuries and stuff on the track. Okay, so now I'm hitting its top speed. That's right at 103 miles an hour, but it'll go over that. Let's see. This run. Oh, look at that. It's got a wing on the back. I think that's got to be like a drag racing wing or something on the back. I gotta admit, that looks pretty cool, and it's got custom air vents on the side to cool the air-cooled engine. But also a flat four-cylinder, like it's always been in the original Beetle. As good as I want, but still, when I tune it, it'll be a hell of a lot better. Next, we will try the Jimcos, starting with the trophy truck. Sound from the Bone Shaker Monster Truck, how about that? And the Twin Turbo LSX 454 from the Funko Motorsports F9 Buggy. Similar looking interior as the other trophy trucks, and yeah, a third screen, you know where the glove box would be. distance for the co-driver, but yet that would still be pretty distracting for the actual driver himself. And there's a few other screens that the co-driver would read over there too. Also pretty distracting for the actual driver when you're in a race, so you gotta be very careful. Traffic cars, they're very annoying. Oh, it's got a 3-speed transmission. I didn't know that. Okay. I was hoping for it to maybe have a 4-speed, but I guess I was wrong. So, I guess they went with 3-speed because they think it's lighter, which it is. But it's still pretty heavy. The whole truck itself is heavy, despite having a lightweight transmission. Got two spare tires in the bed, whereas most of these trophy trucks only have one spare tire. Alright, that's under 30. Oh man, there are so many lags here. That's 132 max, that's pretty good. But still, these lags are really, really bad. Next, we'll try out the other Jimco, the Class 1. This one will be fun. Yeah, this is not doing me any justice here with the lags. It's got to be a custom-built LS or maybe a big block in the back of there. You can see it very well. And it's fast, too. Wow. Look at this. It's fast. It's 5-speed transmission. Same interior, or similar interior as some of the other Class 1 buggies and trucky trucks. But yeah, I think I hit its top speed of 151 or 152, I think. So yeah, that's 152, 53. That's pretty good. But let's see if it'll go a little bit faster. Let's see. Start off probably right back here. It should go a little faster. Also has two spare tires. It picks up and moves pretty quick. I'm impressed. Yeah, it looks like those guys are wanting to race each other. I'm not gonna bother them. I'm just gonna keep moving and doing my own thing. Okay, so here we are at 155, a little bit faster. Man, I apologize for these lags. It usually shouldn't really happen on this app. I mean, it really needs to be updated. It is terrible. Even on the Series X, it's still not doing as good as I thought. Did fine in my Need for Speed video, but right now it's completely sucking. I don't know why. Weird. Definitely they go so they can't do anything to me. Alright, that's 160 miles per hour. 161. Okay, that's better. And now test out the other Polaris RZR. I think there's officially three of them in here now, since this is the third Polaris RZR we get. And I got the second one in a previous update, which is, in my opinion, not as good as the original, even when fully tuned. Let's see how good this is. It should hit over 100 miles an hour, but we'll see. And it only has one gear. Single speed, only one gear. There's a little instrument cluster right in there, a little digital instrument right in there. Yeah, it's gotta be an inline thing, or something like that. Yeah, two-cylinder. It's got enough power to get this moving, but it's not very fast. Cruising at around 92 miles an hour. That's fun. But it'll be more fun when properly tuned, with the maximum horsepower it can get, which I'll find out later. Now, there's ghosts in there, too. There's some monster energy right there. It looks like it's driven by Casey Curry, so Casey Curry is the driver. Hence, the Casey Curry Motorsports is one of the manufacturers in this game. That's probably the one that made the Ultra Ford Trophy Jeep. Yep, that's made by Casey Curry Motorsports. So he probably drives this as well as the Jeep. Who knows? But yeah, you learn something every day. I don't know why it's lagging so much. Pardon me, it's not as good as I thought. I'm gonna have to try some different filming methods next time I do more gaming videos. I have no idea why that this app is complete trash. Just do screen recording and filming and playing online. It is not good at all. It's 97 miles per hour top speed. Oh well, it's decent. But when I modify it and tune it, it'll go way over 100. And who knows, maybe 200. And there we go, that's it. That's all the vehicles in stock form. And so, now I'm gonna tune them all up and then film them all with their maximum horsepower and torque and possible engine swaps, as well as all-wheel drivetrain swaps for every one of them. So, I'll be back when these are fully customized and fully tuned to their maximum potential. So stay tuned. Alright, now all vehicles from the Rally Expansion Pack on Forza Horizon 5 have finally been fully upgraded. And now they are ready for their final top speed run. Starting off with the Alumicraft Class 1 buggy. Now all these vehicles have their maximum horsepower engine swap and are tuned to my specifications. So now my Alumicraft Class 1 buggy rockets from 0 to 60 miles an hour in less than 2 seconds, 1.964 seconds to be exact, and 0 to 100 miles an hour in less than 4 seconds, 3.998 seconds to be exact. Top speed is 189 miles per hour. Lateral G's is both 92 0.92 G's at both 60 and 100 miles an hour. Braking from 60 to 0 is now 104.7 feet. And now, wait a minute, excuse me. Braking from 60 miles an hour to 0 is a whopping 104.7 feet. And braking from 100 miles an hour to 0 is 272 feet. Now, going to go back on the entrance to the highway, then see how fast it'll really go. This one has the RJ Anderson Trophy Truck engine swap with the twin turbos and anti-lag. And man, does it go fast. Getting 180 now. I'm at its top speed. We're almost. We're getting there. Yep, that's it. There's 189. I'm actually going a little bit over its top speed now. It's getting there.
You've arrived at your destination.
I like how it's got two fog lights, search lights on the cab. That's pretty cool. And here, this will hit the real fast. Then 90, and 91, and then 2, 3, 4, 5. Ooh, just shy of 200 miles per hour in this. Wow, what a monster. Next, let's test out the Trick Truck with the same RJ Anderson Pro Truck twin turbo anti-lag V8, both of which have 1,356 horsepower and 1,021 foot-pounds of torque. They're a little bit lighter. The Trick Truck weighs 5,186 pounds, whereas the Class 1 Buggy, Alumacraft, weighs 3,914 pounds. So yeah, significantly lighter than before. Some of these have my favorite rims in this game, which are the Mickey Thompson Classic Lock. It's got the bead lock on it, and it's got 8 bullet holes in it, and these are the wheels I want on my real life car in the future. And I'm going to color them all later. As you can see, they're still in their normal liveries, but I'm going to give them my custom torch red paint, and I'm going to color the wheels yellow and color the beadlock black. And to match the tires, that would look amazing in my opinion. But everyone's got their own styles of paint they like, but that's just me. Now, the Trick Truck rockets from 0 to 60 miles per hour in 2.5 seconds, 2.52 seconds to be exact, 0 to 100 miles per hour in 4.612 seconds, top speed 180.2 miles per hour, lateral G's is I think about the same as before, 0.9 G's at 60 miles an hour and 0.89 G's at 120 miles an hour, a little bit more, a little bit less, I don't know, but yeah, I think it's about the same. Braking distance from 60 miles an hour to 0 is 100 feet flat. Braking from 100 miles an hour to 0 is 253.6 feet. And now let's floor it. Let's go ahead and yeet it and do a full sim rip again. Again with my lagging on my filming screen on my iPad. Ooh, that would have been fantastic. Yeah. It really shouldn't lag like this. It's weird. Alright, I'm just about to hit its top speed. There's 180. Let's see if I can get it over that a little bit more.
Arrived at your destination.
181, that's going a little bit over. I'm liking these trophy trucks, they're fun. It's getting higher, 185, 6, oh, almost 187, that's soon to hit 190, but hey, that's still very fast. And next, we're going to try out the Casey Curry Motorsports Ultra 4 Trophy Jeep, also with the big block Pro Truck Anderson RZR Racing Engine. Rally truck engine with the 7.5 liter maximum displacement. And also with 1,356 horsepower and 1,021 foot-pounds of torque, now weighs 4,768 pounds. So it's still heavy, but definitely a little bit lighter and a lot more powerful. And for its stats, it now rockets from 0 to 60 miles per hour in 2.319 seconds, 0 to 100 miles per hour in 3.534 seconds. Top speed is 168 miles per hour flat. Lateral G's are both 0.93 lateral G's at both 60 and 120 miles per hour, respectively. Braking distance from 60 miles an hour to 0 is 100.9 feet. Braking from 100 miles per hour to 0 is 252.5 feet. And here we go. Here we go. Wow. It's fast. There's 160. It'll definitely keep going, man. But I don't think it's as fast as my Hellcat Jeep, the Trailcat, obviously. So that's got a whopping 1,700 horsepower. It actually went 169 right there. Casey Curry Ultra 4 Jeep. Ooh, there was 170 there. Sorry, there's still a lot of lag on here. Don't know why. I think it's probably because I don't have what's called an Ethernet cable. I think I may need to get an Ethernet cable, which I heard is actually really good and will hopefully prevent lag spikes like this, so hopefully, we'll see. And here we go, 172, 3, 4, ooh, almost 175, that's good. Not bad. Next, we'll try out Colin McRae's Ford Focus RS, which now has the Ford RS200 Hoonigans turbo 4-cylinder. And it now makes... Oops. It now makes nearly 1,100 horsepower on a turbo 4-cylinder. Wow. 1,082 horsepower to be exact, and 805 foot-pounds of torque, weighs 2,428 pounds, 2.4-liter displacement. Excuse me. Now, it rockets from 0 to 60 miles per hour in 1.83 seconds, 0 to 100 miles per hour in 3.35 seconds. Top speed is 254 miles per hour flat. Lateral G's is 1.22 G's at 60 miles per hour and 1.25 G's at 120 miles an hour. Braking from 60 miles an hour to zero is 86.5 feet. And braking from 100 miles per hour to zero is 218.5 feet. Oops. Moving on, here we go. Let's see how fast Colin McRae's car really is. Wow. I wonder if Colin McRae ever drove this fast in his rally racing career. Whoa! We're hitting 240 miles per hour right now. Wow. Yep. This also has the Mickey Thompson wheels on here that I like. Almost 250 now, here we go.
You have arrived at your destination.
Tell me, is Colin McRae still alive right now, or is he dead? I have no idea. I'm just curious. I sure would love for him to see this. This is insane. And here we go. 252, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Wow, that's faster than the Bugatti Veyron. How about that? Wow. Wow, Colin McRae would be proud of this car. He definitely would. Next is the Baja Beetle, Class 5 1600 Scumbug from Hoonigan, with a Porsche 911 GT3 RS flat 6 swapped inside, with 957 horsepower and 628 pounds of torque, and weighs 2,548 pounds. Let me look at the stats real quick. And now rockets from 0 to 60 miles per hour in 2.665 seconds, 0 to 100 miles per hour in 4.77 seconds, 4.07 seconds. And top speed is 194.3 miles per hour, just shy of 200. Now this bug is fast. Lateral G's is 1.9 G's at 60 miles an hour and 0.9 G's at 60 miles an hour and 0.89 G's at 120 miles an hour. Braking distance is 110 feet from 60 miles an hour to zero and 281 feet from 100 miles an hour to zero. And here we go. That Porsche engine sounds sweet, don't it? Because for those of you who don't know, Porsche first used the chassis of a Volkswagen Beetle to make his own car, which he made the 356, which later then became the basis for the 911. The 356 used the same flat four cylinder that this car originally uses, and the 911, of course, uses a flat six, which, of course, Barry Porsche, who designed it, wanted more power. He wanted to make his dad's car a lot faster. Because Ferdinand Porsche originally designed the 356, whereas I think it was Barry Porsche who did the 911. I may be wrong, but yeah. this merges two of those cars into one. And look at that, we're hitting 200 miles per hour in this monster. Wow. I bet Ferdinand and Ferry Porsche would both be very proud. Hitting 200 miles an hour on that Baja scumbug. Baja scumbug? Almost sounds like humbug, as if, you know, your negative feelings toward Christmas. No pun intended, but hey, that's what it kind of sounds like to a degree. Baja scumbug? You get it? Because it almost sounds like Bah humbug. That's kind of funny, right? I mean, to some maybe, but others maybe not. I don't know. Next are the Jimcos with the trophy truck, also with a 1,356 horsepower, 1,021 torque, racing 7.2-liter V8, bored out to 7.5-liter, and twin-turbo with the anti-lag. They all have the anti-lag turbos installed. And it now weighs 4,667 pounds. Now look at its stats. It now rockets from 0 to 60 miles per hour in 2.62 seconds, 0 to 100 miles per hour in 4.66 seconds. Top speed, 174 miles per hour flat, but it'll definitely go way over that. Lateral G's are 1.92 G's at 60 miles an hour. Why do I keep saying 1 point? It's just 0 point, excuse me. Point, or should I say 0.92 G's at 60 miles an hour. And 0.91 G's at 120 miles an hour. Braking from 60 miles an hour to zero is 100 feet. And braking from 100 miles an hour to zero is 251 and a half feet. And here we go. There's the side exhaust, where you can see the anti-lag turbo working, with the flames spitting out of it. Oh, that bus really should have looked really easy. Very smart, although that was partially my fault because I didn't see it. Going a little bit over, that's 175, 6. But hey, close enough. It's pretty quick. The Jimco Hammerhead Class 1 buggy. Also with a 1,356 horsepower, 1,021 torque, pro truck racing engine. Twin turbocharged. And it weighs just under 3,300 pounds. 3,297 to be exact. That's pretty light. And it now has all-wheel drive too. Yep, they all have all-wheel drive. Except this one, along with the Alumacraft Class 1, they're actually pretty interesting because they have other wheels that I like. So the wheels here almost look similar to NASCAR-style wheels. How about that? They got beadlocks on them too. I like that design. Yeah. I think it's probably made from... What is it? Is it JC rims, I think? I can't really make it out from this view, but yeah. But yeah, these rims look very similar to NASCAR to a degree. I like how they look. They look great. I like that style. And now let's look at the stats. It now rockets from 0 to 60 miles per hour in 2.25 seconds. 0 to 100 miles per hour in 3.93 seconds, so almost 4 seconds to 100, but still, that's pretty fast. And top speed is 177.7 miles per hour. Lateral Gs include 0.94G at 60 miles an hour and 0.93G at 120 miles per hour. Braking distance from 60 miles an hour to zero is 101 feet. Braking from 100 miles per hour to zero is 255.7 feet. And here we go. And you can see the flames spewing out of the center exit exhaust where the anti-lag turbo does its work. Where the anti-lag turbo does all of its work. Yep. Whoa, we're going over the top speed now. We're hitting over 180. We're going 183. Wow, this one's pretty fast. It's cool that it's got the two spare tires on the rear. You gotta like that. When you hit these speed zones, the traffic becomes ghostly. So good news is you can't collide into them, so that's good. You go through them. It's only when you exit the speed zone that the traffic comes back to normal, so watch out for them. It's cruising at 184 miles per hour in a Class 1 V8 powered buggy. You gotta love that. How's that for a dune buggy? You gotta love that. Never heard of Jimco before. I may have to study them. They're pretty cool. And I'll probably study up on a Lumicraft too. There's 187. Come on, 188. Come on, baby. Aw, 188. Wow, that's way faster than 177. All right. That's pretty good. There's just a couple more cars I need to try out. Or vehicles, excuse me. For the rally expansion of Horizon 5 that I almost forgot. So, my Polaris RZR Factory Racing Limited Edition has now been upgraded. Engine swapped with the 1.6 liter rally turbo 4-cylinder, board stroke to a 2 liter, and now makes 668 horsepower and 682 foot-pounds of torque, and weighs just under 2,200 pounds. Look at its stats here. It now rockets from 0 to 60 miles per hour in 2.76 seconds and 0 to 100 miles per hour in 6.5 seconds flat. Top speed is 142 miles an hour flat, but I'm sure it'll go over that. Hopefully at 150, we'll see. Lateral Gs include 0.92 Gs at 60 miles per hour and 0.91 Gs at 120 miles per hour. And braking distance from 60 miles an hour to zero is 102.5 feet, and braking from 100 miles per hour to zero is 257.5 feet. And here we go. There's the exhaust. It's a little pipe that you can see right out the back there. It's a straight pipe, I think. And here we go. And it now has a 6-speed transmission that I installed, because the one gear single speed drive, direct drive, whatever, that didn't work for me. That didn't provide the torque band I needed, or RPM band that I needed. So you need more gears if you want to control more speed. That's 142 right there, but it'll definitely go over that, which it is now. It's at 143. Sometimes the numbers aren't very accurate in this game, I've noticed. But they're decent for what they are, I guess. And I apologize for more lag spikes. That's my bad. That was 144, and we also hit 145 a second ago. So yeah, it's going over 142. Not bad. Though I was hoping it would be just a little bit faster, but hey, it's got some pretty good speed, not gonna lie. Here we go, 145. 6, 7. Come on, baby, 148. Oh, that was almost 150. But still, 148 in an ATV or UTV, that's pretty fast. Next, we'll try out. The new and improved Polaris RZR Pro 4 truck from RJ Anderson Racing. Now, with the twin turbo LSX 454, twin turbo small block LS from the Funko Motorsports F9 buggy with a whopping 1,750 horsepower, 1,475 foot-pounds of torque, weighs just under 4,000 pounds, so that's 3,882 pounds. So yeah, it's just shy of 2 tons. That's still pretty light. Now, here's the stats. It now rockets from 0 to 60 miles per hour in 2.17 seconds, and 0 to 100 miles per hour in 3.91 seconds. I don't know how to pronounce that good. Top speed is 190.6 miles per hour. Just a couple more miles an hour faster than the Jimco buggy. How about that? Lateral Gs are now 0.97 Gs at 60 miles per hour and 0.96 Gs at 120 miles per hour. Braking distance from 60 miles per hour to zero in 97.5 feet. And braking from 100 miles per hour to zero in 249.2 feet. And here we go. There's that launch control there. If only we could twin turbo the stock engine in this, that would be insane. It would definitely make more power than this. But yeah, we're already at 190 right now. We're already at its top speed. 191 now. It's going over. 192. Wow. These are definitely monsters. You gotta love them. These trophy trucks are insane. Same with the buggy classes. They are extremely interesting. If you love off-roading and going fast, then these are perfect for you. These trucks race in the Lucas Oil series all the time. Very, very noticeable series, and it's a lot of fun. Even the stadium super trucks are somewhat similar to this, but they strictly race on street courses. And now we're hitting 195. Come on, 196. 197. Whoa! That was just shy of 200 miles per hour in a trophy truck. Dude, that's insane. You gotta love that. Wow. What a beast. And now, I'm going to paint all these vehicles in my signature torch red paint and yellow rims. And when I'm done, I'll show them all to you. And let me know which one is your favorite. I mean, as I mentioned in my Hot Wheels expansion movie, that some people may like my choice of paint, others may not. Or some may like my choice of rims, others may not. But you know, it's all a matter of your own preference. If you like it, good. If not, that's fine. Everyone's got their own tastes. So I'm going to go ahead and paint these vehicles and then screenshot them into a photo collage at the end. And let me know which one is your favorite, and I hope you all enjoyed the Forza Horizon 5 Rally Expansion. Okay, why the hell is this piece of disgusting garbage in this game? Really? Why do we need to have more fucking disgusting garbage electric government vehicles in this game? Why? Because these governments are pushing this agenda, and it's propaganda, probably to start a future world or civil war. I mean, come on. Child slave labor is getting a bunch of injuries and deaths because of this. Because, hey, they're the ones making the lithium and cobalt to make the batteries in this very piece of shit. I mean, at least it looks like a normal F-150, I'll give you that. But why the fuck does it have to be electric? Why? Absolutely disgusting. I mean, just fucking look at it. Seriously? You gotta be fucking kidding me. Really? I mean, that's fucking retarded. Really? Come on, at least a gas V8 would be so much better than this bullshit. It weighs a whopping 7,000 pounds. That's 3.5 tons. That's heavy as fuck. Good luck stopping this piece of shit. Yeah, no wonder Ford went woke and now they're starting to go broke. Yeah, Ford is woke because of this. This is what makes Ford woke. Yep, this is exactly what has wokeness written all over it. This has wokeness, greed, corporate bullshit, and future propaganda all written all over it. It's fucking retarded. I mean, I just can't fucking stand this. And of course, with it being all electric, you can't fucking hear this thing. Because if it's coming towards your ass, it will squash you dead like a bug, and the driver will not even know you're there. This is a mean, lean killing machine. It's made to murder and decapitate people. And it's made to crush people who are ignorant enough not to hear it coming, because they can't hear it. It's ridiculous. This is not the future. No, it's not. This is such bullshit, Ford. I'm starting to lose respect for you. I mean, although, thank God I'm a Chevrolet fan, but I do like Ford as well, but not this kind of Ford. With this... this is making me lose respect for Ford. And not only that, they just made a commercial about their woke agenda. So, they didn't use this truck, which I'm kind of sure they probably would have. Instead, they used a Ranger instead for their new fucking ad campaign, which they basically displayed the woke LGBTQ colors with the rainbow livery painted on the whole truck, which got a shit ton of backlash and pissed a lot of people off, me included. I mean, come on. So Ford now admits they're LGBTQ and they're woke? Really? That's just retarded. And this is pushing the woke agenda even further. Seriously, enough with this shit, Forza and Playground Games. We never asked for it. We never did. All it is just a skateboard chassis with a vehicle body on it. That's all it is. With a tiny motor and battery that can make a shit ton of power and be extremely dangerous to pedestrians around them who can't even hear or see this motherfucker coming. And I said that same thing with that new woke-ass disgusting Mustang SUV thing they came out with, which is also retardedly electric. I mean, whose disgusting idea was this anyway? Why did Ford do this? I mean, why are they starting to poop out EVs left and right and even admitting to going woke? Why? This is retarded and ridiculous. And I'm not going to keep this. So I'm actually going to sell it because I don't even know why I got it in the first place. All I did was just win this as an award from completing a task in the Rally Adventure and shit like that. But yeah, it gave me this of all things. Are you kidding me? I'm going to get rid of this right away. I did drive it for about a few miles, hated it. Did not want anything else to do with it. No, not one bit. Not one bit at all. So I'm going to sell this piece of garbage and hopefully make a very sweet profit off of it. And I prefer the term automotive capitalist, because this is gonna make everyone all rich if you sell it on the auction house. Oh yeah, it will sell for big bucks. It better, because yeah, who knows how expensive those EV batteries are? They cost a fortune to replace. We're talking over 10,000 plus US dollars. That's a lot, but in this game, it's probably worth a couple mil or 20 mil or something, which is the max buyout price. So yeah, hopefully this will sell for a lot. But instead, I'm going to actually see if there are any weird woke paint jobs for this. I'm going to go ahead and look at the fine new designs thing and see if there's any woke stuff on here. Well, that's its ordinary one. Let's see. No. Well, that's all recommended designs. So let's see if we can search it up here. Let's see. Let's see. I'll type in rainbow, because yeah, it's bound to be on here. It's got to be. Okay, really? Hold on. No, actually. This is to a lot of these other cars and stuff. But, yeah, I can see why that's pretty woke. But actually, wait, let me try this. Rainbow. Not entirely rainbow, but I can see a little bit of little abstract colors in there, but nah, it ain't that, but still, it's woke. Fuck it. Cause yeah, Ford is officially losing my respect because of all the shit they're doing right now with the downsized EcoBoost engines and putting away the beautiful V8s that we all know and love. Cause at least they're still putting V8s in the F-250 and up and the Mustang. The real Mustang, well, God knows for how much longer. But still, they're trying to push the woke electric agenda. And it's disgusting. That's what they're really trying to do. It's like they're bullying people into getting that. It's fucking terrible. Let me show you the other Ford here that I think should have that disgusting flag thing. Okay, so... Oops, not this one. Nope, not this. No, let me... actually, yeah, let me look at... Let me see if this one has it. Let's see. Oops. Hold on. Let's see. That looks like General Lee. Let's see, search rainbow. Let's see. Oops. Oh, God. No. Look at this. Yeah, that's woke Ford for you. Look at this. Yeah, some people actually made woke rainbow liveries for this. You have got to be kidding me. Oh, my God. I can't believe Ford is catering to the woke LGBTQ community with shit like this. Wow. And Ford now admits they're woke and all that disgusting garbage. Really? Yeah, but that was part of it. But what I saw in the commercial was a bit different than that. Let's see if we can find it here. Let's see. There we go. Aha! I knew it! Yes! I found the culprit! Yep. This is what made Ford woke in their recent commercial. Just look at this design! And this one too! Look at that! That has wokeness written all over it. Look at that. For the LGBTQ community, oh my God, you gotta be kidding me, Ford. Why did you do that? That is disgusting. First you're making electric vehicles, and now you're woke? Man, I'm starting to lose respect for you, Ford. Come on. That's ridiculous. You're pushing an agenda. This is an agenda that you're pushing. And you're driving your once loyal customers away from you because of this disgusting garbage. Really? Why? It's terrible. I can't believe this, Ford. I mean, why? I cannot believe this. Yeah, I'm about to lose respect for Ford for doing this crap. I mean, well, but listen, just a disclaimer. Yes, I admit, I do have some friends and some family members on the LGBTQ community. So I'm not trying to offend them or anything. I'm just stating, you know, what recently happened with Ford that drove a lot of their customers away. Because that's what they think is wrong and stuff like that. But of course, there's a lot of lesbian, gay, bisexual, career, even trans people that are kind and friendly, but there's some that aren't. So you got to be really, really careful about who you're talking to and what you say to them and stuff like that. But yeah, you know, but yeah, I'm pretty disappointed that Ford, of all manufacturers, did this, and they actually admitted it. I can't believe it. It's ridiculous. But of course, I want to give a shout out to my friend Ash Meadows, who is part of the LGBTQ community, as well as some of my other friends and two of my cousins as well. actually four of my cousins. You know, I don't want to disrespect them in any way. I really don't, because I love them and I care about them for their well-being, you know? It's just that what Ford did is very disappointing to me and a lot of other, you know, and a lot of their other longtime fans and customers are starting to lose respect for Ford and get driven away from them. Probably switch to Chevrolet or Dodge, who hopefully did not go down this route or should never go down this route, period. But yeah, if that's how you want to represent a car company, that is not the way to do it. Come on, Ford. What the hell were you thinking? What kind of drugs were you smoking? Really? How awful and disgusting. I can't believe Ford did this. And they're promoting it. To Forza, Facebook, Instagram, YouTube, everywhere. It's ridiculous. It's disgusting. And this really needs to stop. Because, yeah, Ford's going to get sued by this one day. I've got a feeling. Yeah, it's pretty sad. I'm not a fan of what Ford's doing right now. I guess it's safe to say that I'm officially losing respect for Ford, or just officially lost respect for Ford altogether. Because, yeah, I mean, Ford made great stuff. Hell, they made the first monster truck, and that's Bigfoot, back in the 70s and 80s. That was back then, back when Ford were smart and free and fun and friendly and enjoyable to all people. And actually care about making a quality product instead of catering to a specific agenda or cause. Unlike now, which is really sad. I cannot believe this. Wow. I guess it's safe to say from Ford making the first mass-produced assembly line is now the first manufacturer to go completely woke. This is just, it's insane. It's driving a lot of people, especially Ford owners and customers, insane. And even non-Ford car enthusiasts insane. I mean, what's the significance of this? I mean, come on. People in the LGBTQ community, they're just like everyone else. I mean, sure, they have differences in, you know, the people they like and, you know, how they view things and how they view themselves. I get that. You know, if you want to be that way, cool, that's fine. But you don't have to shove it in everyone else's face and look like a motherfucker doing it. You don't have to do that. I mean, come on. That is not the way to do it. That's not the way to go. Why? Why, Ford, are you doing this? Just why? We never asked for this, Ford. This is absolutely disgusting. Very disgusting. Oops. And yeah, back to this piece of shit, which, how in the hell does this make 563 horsepower and 775 foot-pounds of torque on a tiny little electric motor? How does that even happen? Wait, maybe it's because of the battery capacity, because it's so damn heavy. Look at the weight. Nearly 7,100 pounds. That's 2.5 tons. Wait, blah. No, that's 3.5 tons. That is extremely heavy. That's just borderline insane. And not in a good way. And it's stuck in B-class, which is where it should be. And of course, I drove it, did not like it one bit. And I'm going to sell it to a lucky buyer on the Forza Horizon 5 auction house for some good old sweet cash. This is going to make me rich in Forza Horizon 5. I wonder how much this will sell for. Probably a lot, due to how much the battery is worth. Yeah, I can kind of see that. Definitely. Yep. But yeah, like I said, I really hate that this route that Ford is taking is not a good idea. I don't know why they're doing this, and I don't know how they're doing this, and I don't know why they're intentionally trying to scare or piss off their customers or fan bases. I mean, this is soon going to probably start U.S. Civil War 2.0 or World War 3 if more EV shit like this just keeps getting pooped out and are trying to erase the internal combustion engine itself from total existence. God help us all. A war is coming, ladies and gentlemen, and we have to be prepared to fight. We do not want electric vehicles to conquer all of our roads and highways. We still need gas and diesel, and there's still a room for oil anywhere else. We need oil, we need gas, we need diesel. Hell, we also need hydrogen and propane and natural gas. Those are starting to get plentiful. Why can't people do more research into those? And, you know, like have retrofit kits for existing gas and diesel powered vehicles to help them actually get better fuel mileage, as well as zero tailpipe emissions. Going all battery electric is not the way to go on there, because the process in making a battery EV is very deadly and very painful and stupidly expensive. And it's just downright disgusting. When it comes to the F-150 Lightning, I love the older SVT Lightning from the 2000s. Now that was a good truck, and it was powered by a V8 gas engine, which I liked, and there was even a version from the 90s as well, one of which Lady Gaga also owns. Hard to believe. But yeah, I can't believe Ford went all woke when they made something like this. And they put the rainbow livery on their new Ranger that just came out. You have got to be kidding me. I mean, no offense to the LGBTQ community, but, you know, but yeah, this thing has got to stop. You know, if you're gay, lesbian, bisexual, queer, cool. That's fine. Go ahead, do what you do what you want to do, be what you want to be. Just don't shove it in everyone else's faces that might not want to know about it or might not want to understand it, like you do. You know, just keep it to yourself. That's all that we're asking. Keep it to yourself. But of course, I support those who are in the LGBTQ community, because, like I said, I have friends and some cousins who are part of that community too, and I love them and respect them for that. You know? It's important to have good communication. I mean, sure, we have differences, but you got to learn to put those differences aside, which we all did. Because, you know, we treat each other as equals, no matter what sexuality we come from or identity or whatever. You know, you are who you are. You know, you do what you do, you be what you be, all right? And that's cool. And call it a day. Just don't go around shoving it in people's faces and, you know, like shoving it down their throats because you think it's cute or cool, which it ain't. I can't believe Ford is doing this. I mean, I'm losing respect for Ford just because of shit like this. It's disgusting. It really is. In fact, I'm gonna sell this piece of shit EV truck for a very hefty profit. Now, I'm going to get in a proper vehicle with an engine. Let's see. How about this? Yeah, this is a better one. I'll get into this, which is much, much better and much, much more iconic, and during an era where wokeness did not exist. And now, let's go to the auction house and sell that piece of garbage. All right, let's see how much this sells for. Ooh, mama, look at that, a cool mill. Oh, this is gonna make me all rich, yes. Oh, yeah. Money, 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 money. Oh, yeah. I can't imagine all those dollars went into that. Oh, 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 yeah. That's where the money is right there. Let's see. Let's start it off at right about here. And then see what happens over the course of 24 hours. And if this thing gets out of my life for good, I'll be happy. Yeah, I want this thing out of my life. I don't need it in Forza or in real life. I don't need any EVs. No, not for me. All right. Let's hope this piece of trash gets sold and I make a sweet profit. Which I hope so very soon. And yeah, like I said, so I apologize to my friends and family members who are on the LGBTQ community, but hear me out. I mean, this thing that Ford did is borderline insane. You know, they shouldn't have done this, and it's not cute, it's not cool in any way. You know, it's driving their customers away. It is, and all that. Now, Ashmados and Leia Bray and my cousin Josh, I want you all to know that, you know, I don't mean you all any harm or wrongdoing by this, okay? Look, I want you to know that I love you all and respect you all for who you are. It's just that I don't like this thing that Ford did, which is really over-the-top ridiculous. And, you know, feel free to agree or disagree, but at the end of the day, that's just my opinion, all right? I just want you to know that, okay? But, yeah. So, you know, I just wanted you all to understand my point of view and where that came from. And, of course, I understand your point of view because, you know, like, you guys want to be represented. I get that, okay? I understand. You know, there's nothing wrong with that, okay? You know, but I'm glad you're not like some of those other ones that go around bitching to everyone that it should be liked and represented, because you guys are actually kind of sweet. I'm talking about the ones that are nasty and evil and try to shove it in your faces and prove that they're superior to you. Those are the kinds of people I don't like. But you guys are great because, you know, even though you're part of that community, you know, we're family and we're friends, you know. I love you all and respect you all for who you are. There's no harm in that. And I just want you to all understand my point of view, where I'm coming from this, and I really don't want to offend anybody, and I apologize if I did. Now, I'm just getting this point across. I just don't like that Ford, of all manufacturers of vehicles, did this. You know, they shouldn't have done this, and they're basically alienating their fan base, just like Star Wars is, and Disney as a whole. So, yeah. I mean, I feel worried for you guys. I do feel worried for you all at the same time. So, just be careful out there, and I wish you all good luck. I love you all very much for who you are, and you know that's good that you're a part of that community, but you know, just be kind and be sweet and be generous and be welcoming, but at the same time, do not, and I repeat, do not shove it in other people's faces or you know, try to act superior over them. In other words, don't be an asshole, don't be a dick, and we'll all be friends and family, you know. That's my point, okay? I just hope you all understand that. But yeah, enough of that rant. I hope you all enjoyed my Forza Horizon 5 video review of the Rally expansion. And more Forza and Crossout and SnowRunner videos will be coming up later on. Thanks for watching.